Now students, after learning all the properties of angle formed by two parallel lines and a transversal, let's solve practice set 2.2. Now here, last class we have solved practice set 1.1. Now today, what we have learned? We learn here property of corresponding angle, property of interior alternate angle, property of interior angle. Now, and also we have learned property of exterior angle. Now here, practice set 2.2 is based on all those property which I taught you. Now here, practice set 2.2, question number 1. Choose the correct alternative. Now here, question number 1. In the question number 1, sub-question 1, in the adjoining figure. This is the adjoining figure given. In the adjoining figure, if line M parallel to line N, and P is the transversal line. P is the transversal line. Then find X. Here four alternates are given. Here we have to choose which one is the correct. So let's start our sums with solution. So before writing solution, we have to write here. See, line M parallel to line N. This is optional. No need to make this figure. Okay. This is for your understanding. Don't need to make this figure. Only you have to calculate here measure of angle X. So here line M parallel to line N. Line M parallel to line N and P is the transversal line. Then measure of angle. See here I have written here a few points. So here I have written M. Okay. Here I have written M. Here I have given Q. Similarly here I have written N. Here I have written S point, here R point, here P point, here N point, and here already given B. So here A and B, okay, this P, transversal line P represent A and B, whereas this two parallel line M and N represent PQ parallel to RS, okay. Now here 3X and X. So here we will write measure of angle QMN. Supplementary angle we have to take. Interior angle on the same side of a transversal as supplementary. Now here QMN. Okay, this is the interior side. So QMN plus we have to add this SNM. So QMN plus SNM is equal to 180 degrees. So measure of angle QMN plus measure of angle SNM is equal to 180 degrees. This is the interior angle. This is the interior angles. So QMN plus MNS. So measure of angle QMN plus measure of angle SNM. Measure of angle SNM is equal to how much? Is equal to 180 degrees. Pair of interior angle on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. Why? Because it is 180 degree. Now here, substituting the value in the given equation. So here, for measure of angle QMN, 3x is given. And for measure of angle SNM, x is given. So here, 3x plus x is equal to 180 we have to take. Here M, measure of angle M is 3x and measure of angle N is x. So here we will write substituting the value in the above equation. That is we get here 3x plus x is equal to 180. So 3x plus 1x is equal to 4x. So here 3x plus 1x give us 4x. 4x is equal to 180. So here we will apply division rule. So x will be on left hand side. And 4 will go down to this 180. So, because we have divide, we are going to divide this. Okay. We are using here division operation. So, 4x is equal to 180. That is, x is equal to 180 upon 4. X is equal to 180 degree upon 4. So, here 4, after dividing 180 by 4, we will get here 4 ones are 4, 4 fours are 16, 2 here, 4 fives are 20. That means 45 degrees. So x is equal to 45 degrees. So here option is option C. So the correct option is The correct answer option number C. So the correct option is C, that is 45 degrees. So students, in this way we finish question number 1, sub question 1. Now here, very important, no need to write all this. This is for your understanding. I have to show you your interior alternate angle. That's why I have given you this explanation. Only you have to write here is this part. This is important part. Why? Because question says that choose the correct alternate. No need to write all this. But why I am teaching you all this? Because this is the basic thing which is based on your 9th standard topic, that is parallel line. So if your base is strong, you can easily attain each and every sums. So from today, we will start, we will learn some new things. Okay? So that's why I have added all this. So here, 3x plus x is equal to 180. So here, 3x plus 1x, 4x is equal to 180. X will be on left hand side, 4 will go down. So 180 divided by 4 gives us 45 degrees. So the correct option is 45. So students, in this way we finish practice set 2.2, question number 1, sub question 1. Next, we will solve question number 1, sub question 2. Now students, let's solve practice set 2.2, question number 1, sub question 2. Now here, in the adjoining figure, if line A parallel to line B, that means line A parallel to line B, and line L is the transversal line. This line is the transversal line, line L. Line L is the transversal line. Line A and line B are parallel lines. Here, we have to calculate here x, that means 4x and 2x. This x we have to calculate here. So what we will do here, simply linear pair of angle, what says that interior linear pair of angle says alternate angle. Interior alternate angle says that 180 degree. So here 4x and 2x, interior alternate angles, opposite side, opposite direction. So 4x and 2x, alternate interior angle. Angles are interior, but they are alternate. So here 4x plus 2x is equal to 180 degree. So here we will write solution 4x. First we will write the given, that is line A parallel to line B, which is there in our question, line A parallel to line B. And line L is the transversal line. Then here 2x plus 4x is equal to 180 degree. Pair of linear pair of an angle. So 2x plus 4x is equal to 180 degree. So 2x plus 4x give us 6x is equal to 180 degree. So x will be on left hand side, and here 180 upon 6. 180 divided by 6. So here x is equal to 180 divided by 6 give us 30. After dividing this 180 by 6, we get here 6. So 6 ones are 6, 6 threes are 18, 0 as it is. So 6 x is equal to 30. 6 into 30, 180. So x is equal to 30 degree. So the correct option is option D. So here we will write, so the correct answer is option D. So students, in this way we finish practice set 2.2, question number 1, sub question 1 and sub question 2. Now next slide we will solve question number 2 of this practice set. Now students, let's solve practice set 2.2, question number 2. Here, in the adjoining figure, line P parallel to line Q. Line P parallel to line Q. And here, line T and line S. Line T and line S are transversal line. Line T and line S are transversal line. Previous sums, we saw only one transversal line. But now here there are two parallel line and two transversal line. Find measure. Now here two transversal line name as line T and line S are transversals. Find measure of angle X. Find measure of angle X and measure of angle Y. That means this, measure of angle X and measure of angle Y using the measures of angle given in figure. So here, how many angles are given? There are two angles, that is 40 degree and 70 degree. Measure of angle 40 degree and 70 degree are given. On the base of this, we have to find the remaining angle. So let's start the sums with solution. But before, we'll draw the same diagram here. So here, let us mark the point P and Q. Let us mark the point P and Q on P. So here, let us mark the point P and Q on P, R and S on R, and A and B on T, and C and D on S. So here we will see the next figure. This figure we have to draw. So here, let us mark the point P. Let us mark the point P on line P. So here P and Q, we have to plot this point. So P and Q represent point line P. And similarly here, A and B. Similarly here, R and S. R and S represent line Q, which are parallel with P. And here, line A and B, representing on T, line T. And here, line C and D, point C and D representing line S. So here, suppose PQ and AB intersect at K. Suppose PQ and AB intersect at K, PQ and CD intersect at X. So suppose RS and AB intersect at L and RS and CD intersect at Y. So here we are assuming that PQ and AB intersecting at K and PQ and CD intersect at X. We are assuming this. Similarly, we are also assuming that RS and AB intersect at L and RS and CD intersect at Y. Now here, since AB is a straight line, ray KQ stand on it. So that means this ray KQ. AB is a straight line and KQ stand on it. So this KQ is ray. And angle AKX, plus measure of angle AKX is 40 degree. See here, this K is 40 degree. Measure of angle AKX plus measure of angle XKL. We have to find this XKL. So for X, Y is given, and for K, 40 is given. So here we will write AXK 40 degree, and here XKL is equal to 180 degree. So XKL we will write 40 degree, but for AKX we have to write something. So here what we will write? AXK 40 degree, AXK 40 degree, and AKX is how much? 40 degree, and here XX, and here XKL is equal to 180 degree. So here 40 degree plus XKL, okay, so is equal to 180 degree. Here we have to calculate this is XKL. So we have to subtract this. So measure of angle XKL is equal to 180 minus 40 give us 140 degree. So measure of angle XKL is equal to 40 degree. So XKL, that means this K is 40 degree. Here for AKX, K is 40 degree. But for XKL, we have to calculate here. So here, after subtracting 180 minus 40, we get here 140 degree. So measure of angle XKL is how much? 140 degree. Now in this way we finish this. Now second, P parallel to Q. Now here again P parallel to Q and T is the transversal line. T is the transversal. Then here YLP. Here YLP. 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 Okay. YLP. This YLP. YLP. YLB. YLB. The external part. YLB is equal to YLB is equal to XKL. 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 YLB is equal to X, this X, K and L. So here they both are equal. Why? Why? Because they are corresponding angle, same side, same direction. So here we will write 140 degree. Why? Because here we get XKL 140 degree. That means YLB is also 180 degree. Same side, same direction, corresponding angle property rule says that. Now here next, since RS and CD are two straight line, RS and CD are two straight line intersecting at Y. RS and CD are two straight line, but here intersection is Y. Intersection is Y. Then measure of angle XYL. Measure of angle XYL. This measure of angle X, this X, Y and L is equal to measure of angle SYD. Measure of angle SYD. SYD. They are vertically opposite angle. XYL and SYD. They are vertically opposite angles. So XYL and SYD, they are vertically opposite angle. So if SYD is 70 degree, that means XYL is also 70 degree. So here we will write XYL is equal to 70 degree because it is vertically opposite angle. Now since P parallel to Q and S is a transversal, then P parallel to Q, P parallel line, P parallel to line Q and S is the transversal line. Here KXY plus X, measure of angle KXY plus measure of angle XYL is equal to 180 degree. Interior angle on same side of transversal are supplementary. Interior angle of same side of transversal are supplementary. Now here they are interior angle. This part is the interior angle. KXY and XYL is equal to 180 degree. Now we have here XYL. What is the value for XYL? Yes, vertically opposite angle we have written this 70 degree here. So here XYL is 70 degree, but we don't know KXY. So here we will write KXY plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. So for KXY we will write here angle Y, measure of angle Y. Okay, here we don't have measure, so we will put here Y. Y plus 70 is equal to 180. Here this 70 is on plus side. Then if it is moved from left to right, it will the sign will change, so it will become minus 70. So Y is equal to 180 minus 70, which give us, yes, 110 degree. So Y is equal to 110. So here what we have calculate here, X degree and Y degree, measure of angle X is how much? 140 degree, and measure of angle Y is 110 degree. Here measure of angle XKL is 140 degree and measure of angle XYL is 70 degree. So students, in this way we finish practice set 2.2, question number 1 and question number 2. Now in next class we will solve the remaining sums of this practice set. So enjoy learning, stay healthy, stay safe.